Hello and welcome to my next recording session, learning session about design patterns. Who am I? My name is Alexander Freelancer out of Germany. Here you have my contact information, what kind of services I do provide to my clients, software development, creating automatic unit tests, doing the requirements engineering, advising companies, helping people, job seekers to find permanent positions in German companies. And if you're interested, just say hello to my contact information, which you see here. And now proceed to the following topic, which is Mediator Design Pattern. So basically, the book provides additional pattern. This pattern actually, as you see, an example help you to decouple the messaging between different type of classes. So, and it handles the requests from other parts of the application, and basically allowing you to have kind of reusability of objects which supported by Mediator, and it's decoupling them from the system. It simplifies the maintenance of the system which you created. It simplifies and reduces the variety of messages which sent between objects. And yeah, major drawbacks: Mediator is commonly used to coordinate related GUI components. And another drawback, it is without proper design, it's kind of, yeah, very complex, can be done, but with very high complexity. Let me show you the UML example. I took pretty simplified one from the tutorials point page design patterns, which is have a lot of different other mediator patterns. So basically they have following pattern. I have my user and I have the chat room, and I need to kind of maintain the messages between user and the chat room. So let's look at the code. First of all, I'll show you my test. Here I'm testing if I can create its objects like chat room, like user object. And once more, I have my user and I have my chat room. So what chat room does, just show the message. And the user, yeah, it's kind of obvious. It's just populate the fields and send the message. So basically, let's look how it works. So show mediator pattern running. So basically, if you think there should be an additional class, but I use my test to have mediator like behavior. So basically my test runs the messages between the clients. And let's just execute it. And you see clearly that here's Robert says hi John, and John says hello Robert. But each of the user, they have no dependency on each other, and all happens through this method, show mediator pattern running. And this is how it's supposed to be done. Probably I should actually refactor this code to another class and then call this class in the test. And this will be the case, but I done such a way because I don't want to do additional work for that. And let's just go to the drawing board. Basically, what to say about this design pattern. So all of the involved classes by this pattern, they have no idea. They have no idea about calendar class has no idea about the coffee pot, And CoffeePot has no idea about alarm. But the mediator knows about what happening, in which environment it exists. So it receives messages from different type of services and then should forward these messages to the appropriate according to the behavior of this message to the class which you need to send the message. So basically, if alarm clock want to say information to the sprinkler, it do some call to the mediator and the mediator forward it to the sprinkler. But it should of course make sure that only the right type of information go to the right device, so to speak. And practical way of understanding, does it apply, is there any practical usage of this mediator design pattern? I would definitely say yes. Like, I don't know, imagine that you have a big logistic system where you have many trucks and you need to somehow to communicate between the trucks the information about where they are, the position of the trucks, and you're supposed to track these trucks from your system. Or one tracker want to send a message to another tracker. Maybe he got and somehow into the problem. So it's basically a pretty practical design pattern. I agree with the book. It can be overly complex. Before you know, you need to manage, I don't know, 1,000 or even more messages through your system. And it's not fun. And if you have a legacy system, it's even more crazier, because then you have some messages which are not supposed to happen actually. And then it's kind of hard to debug from which source it got into the system. So my basic idea, if you have at least 5 classes, 10 classes, you should be able to understand from which class the message got into your mediator. But if you have more than that, if you start to work with 20 and up, then probably should think about refactoring. I don't know, having like, let me just clean the stuff. Can I clean it? I just use another paper. So basically what I'm suggesting, the right way to use a mediator would be like having one mediator, then second mediator, and then the classes. And then when I copy it, so basically you have your classes like that, for example. And on other state, and now basically you need to communicate in such a way. So this is a communication between, I will just write the lines, but you can imagine this is two-side communication between each of the objects. And the basic idea, not to overly do a complex system, but having like, I don't know, having system which can send and receive messages not only from the nodes. I would say the smaller circles are the nodes in your system. Let me just quickly look it up. Rings. The smaller rings are the nodes, and each of the node, it does not doesn't it have no clue about the outside of the world, and your mediator M, it's a mediator, it communicates the messages between nodes and mediator itself. This will be like the strategy which I propose to you, because if you have one mediator and 100 classes which you need to mediate, then you have a problem. But you can actually have a system where you have mediator, mediator 1, mediator 2, and then additionally communication between two mediators. Sure, you can actually have additional class which always check if it is valid request of not some sort of a proxy which handles the request, but this is would be like more advanced design pattern. But I say make always sure that you have understanding of the behaviors of your classes which you use in your project, because I mean in most project where I was involved, I saw you always kind of crazy stuff, like having pretty old system where nobody have a clue, and where mediator is used, it was like one got object mediator handling a thousand or even more class types. And this is not a proper solution. You should always strive for less complexity. Complexity always is inherited stuff most times. It is not stuff which obvious. It is not stuff which has was developed like I don't know. Sure, some crazy design architects are like the crazy complexity, but it is not. Sometimes it's not intentionally created. So if you always aware of such problems, your job as a professional programmer to negotiate the complexity, make it sure that all involved parties know about the challenge, and try to speak with the architect and have common reason to tell the architect that you're not doing the right architecture for your domain, problem domain. So this is would be my proposal to think about of it. And mediator itself, as I said earlier, is not the 100% solution for bigger systems. It's solution at best for the problem which you can solve, but it is not silver bullet, as all of the design patterns which I have previously showed to you. It's only one part of the solution of the of your problem. But with that, I conclude the mediator pattern, and one pattern to go, which will be, let me quickly do memento, and this will be the separate video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.